This pair of pants has 3 pattern pieces. No zippers, no pockets, no buttons. You'll need some thread and some elastic. I use 1¼-inch wide elastic. You can use 1-inch elastic. I would suggest at least 1-inch or 1¼. But they're your pants. You put whatever you want to in them, okay? So, I just want to show you, remind you. Here's my fronts. I have marked with a big X and an F. A big X and an F. They're on the wrong side. Because when I get these apart from each other, if I did not have those marks, I would not know what I was using for the right side of the fabric and what I was using for the back side of the fabric. Those marks come off with an iron. You saw me in a video a while back show you about the friction pants. This is another one, friction marker. I have them at both houses. So, here's my two fronts. If they get away from each other and one of them walks downstairs or jumps out the window or something, I will always know when I find it if it's a front or a back and which side is the right side. Here's the backs. I've marked the big X and a BK that these are the two backs. This is the right side on the inside. Okay? So if they get separated from each other, I will know what pieces they are. If you don't have marks on these cut-out fabric pieces, you're not going to know what they are. You are not. You could go back and put them up with the paper pattern, ask me how I know, and then you can figure out if it's a front, if it's a back, if it's a right, if it's a left, and all of that, okay? Much easier to just mark it. And then here's the other piece. This is piece 5. And it is the entire with the fabric waistband. And I have X's on the back to show that's the wrong side. This is the right side. And you can see I've got 2 little marks to show where the center front is of this waistband. Okay? So that's my 5 pieces. So what's step 1? This is step 1 Joy style. Everybody knows that. This is just Joy's way of making a pair of pants, okay? So we're going to start with, we're going to pick up a back and a back. You could pick up a front and a front. I'm starting with the backs. I'm going over to the ironing board. Come with me. I am going to go ahead right now, before I do any sewing at all, and I'm going to iron the creases in my backs and in my fronts. I'm starting with the backs because the backs don't need a dart. Okay? So, you're going to fold it wrong sides together because you don't want your crease on the inside of your leg. That would look really, really strange on the outside. So, I am going to press it, and you always ask me what iron I have, and I always tell you. This is called the Rowenta Perfect Steam. I'll put a link to it down below if anybody wants to buy it. It's on Amazon. It's not cheap, but it's an awesome iron. I buy a new iron every couple of years. So I am going to, how do I know where to put the crease? Very easy. You fold the pant in half. See, it's perfectly in half. And it matches up this far. It matches equally on both sides up this far. Then, because of the crotch and because of the top that goes around your belly and your butt and everything, it gets off. So just follow your crease up to the top and don't worry about this part that's crooked. See up there? Don't try to line that up. Leave it like it wants to be. Follow this crease, this fold, this center fold here, follow it to the top and press it. It's much, much, much easier to put the crease in now than it is to try to put the crease in when your pants are all done. Alright? Hot forgets, cold remembers. So we're not going to open this up until it gets cold. We're going to put it right there and just let it have a little nap. Now we're going to take our other back. We're going to fold it with the right side out like it's going to be on our body. We're going to do the exact same thing. If your pants don't line up at least halfway up, you've cut them out wrong. Something's wrong. Because you have that grain line on your paper pattern and everything is drawn from that grain line, and that keeps everything even from your thigh down. And again, it's off from the crotch up. That's okay. We're going to just follow the crease up to where it wants to be, the way it wants to be, from the bottom. Hot forgets, cool remembers. So when we press something, when we press a hem, when we press a crease, we let it cool off. Because then, when we open it up, it won't just fall out and forget we even put it down. Now, it's obvious now what the right side is of these pants, because here's the crease, okay? While these two backs are cooling, I'm going to go over to the table, pick up the two fronts. I'm going to take the two fronts over to my sewing machine, and I'm going to sew in the dart. There's one dart on the front, so there'll be one dart here and one dart here. I'm going to go sew those darts in because when I put the crease in the front, I want it to match up with that dart. Remember, I have moved the dart on my pattern, so that will happen. I'll meet you at the sewing machine and we'll sew darts. Okay, we're going to take these fronts and we're going to sew these darts. I have marked the darts so you can see them from across the street. Do you see there? I like to see my darts. I'm going to pin the darts in and then I'm going to sew the darts. My sewing machine is a Bernina B740. I love this machine because it has the easy feed foot on the top. I can sew without it, but since I have it, I'm going to use it. Okay, so we're going to fold the dart in. Fold the dart in. Where do I start sewing my darts? I start sewing my darts at the wide part at the top. I used to sew them from the point, but I learned that there was a better way to do it. I don't know when I learned this or if I just started doing it that way or what. I know Peggy always sews hers. Peggy, why are you always talking about Peggy? Because I watch Peggy every single week, twice one week, and every Thursday of every week, and every other Tuesday of the other weeks. So I watch Peggy a lot, so Peggy's always on my mind. And people ask her the same questions over and over and over and over. I bet they've asked her 5,000 times, how do you sew a dart? I'm going to put my finger down and hold my tails of my thread when I start. Now I'm assuming that you ladies know how to sew and you know your sewing machine. I always, always clean my sewing machine and oil it before I start a new project, okay? Always, always, because I can't remember what I made last and I can't remember when I cleaned it last. Now, as I get toward the point, I turn my stitches down. I'm going to turn them down to 2 and I'm just going to sew off the point. I'm going to keep on sewing. Then I'm going to lift up the foot. Pardon my phone, I need to turn it off. Pardon the foot? That didn't make any sense. Pardon the phone. I lift up the foot and I take a couple stitches and I attach this tail and then I cut it. Okay? So, oh, you know what? I should be sewing with a color thread that doesn't match. But I think you guys know how to sew. You don't need me to show you how to sew. So, there's my dart. There's the back. And here's the front. It makes a really good dart. You may find that the dart that you have drawn might be too long, might be too short, might be too thick, might need to be thinner, might need to be fatter. Darts can be so many different ways. They really can. And don't forget that I've got both of my sides of my pants cut out for my high hip. A lot of you have said, what do you do? When do you do it? I'll show you. I haven't done anything about the high hip, low hip yet. I have not done anything. I'm putting the pin in and out, in and out, in and out, making sure that my lines match on the front and the back. My dart lines. It helps if you draw the center line of your dart, but I just don't. I don't know why. When you've sewn 10 trillion things, sometimes you can just skip steps. And that's one that I skip. These sewing machines are all so different in how they sew. Okay, I'm going to hold the tail again. Now, put it back up on 2.5. You actually can sew using 3. I will sew the main seams in this pants with a 3.0 stitch length. Why? It's a whole lot easier to rip it out. I'm sewing off the point. I'm lifting up my foot. I'm going back up, and I'm taking several stitches to tie that down. And I'll show it to you close in the camera. Just hold on 1 second for me. Here, you can see the tail. That's the tail where I sewed off. And then I came back up and I tacked it down right here. So that is never going to come unraveled or come off. Why do you want to do that? Because you don't want a backspace here on this point. It is really hard for a point to look good when you sew a point into something. See? Isn't that nice? That's because I didn't sew backwards and do a back tack on that point. It didn't even press yet. And look how good it looks. Really good. And here's my marks. There's the F for the front and the X showing. This is the wrong side. So my dart better be on the side those are on. Now we're going to go over to the iron and we're going to press the creases in these two fronts. I'll meet you at the iron. Our two backs have been having a nap while I put the darts in the two fronts. So the pleats should be nice and permanent. Look at that. Isn't that nice? Now, if you don't like pleats in your pants, don't put them. I like pleats in my pants. So I always put them. They're always so wrinkled anyway. I don't think anybody can ever see them. When you're sewing with cotton, it does wrinkle. What am I sewing with? I'm sewing with those twill that has a little bit of stretch. Might be called a denim. I'm not sure. What way do you press your darts? It doesn't really matter. I'm pressing mine. I'm pressing mine to the center, I think. They don't seem to want to lay that way, though, so I'm going to press them the other way. I'm going to press mine to the side. Doesn't matter. Here's another dart in the front. There are dart rules, but there's no dart police. Okay, pressing them to the front. And if you've done a good job sewing your dart in, they'll look absolutely beautiful. All right, so my darts are in, my darts are pressed. All I did was put it down and hold up the tip and press it, okay? Press it the way it's gonna go. You don't really need to use the ham there, but if you don't have a ham, ladies, if you don't have a ham, ladies, and I don't know, are there any gentlemen out there? Now this crease goes directly into that dart. If you draw it according to the pattern, it won't. But I move mine because I like the crease to come up my belly into the dart. You can put yours wherever you want to. You can put two darts. Some people need two darts. Some people don't need any darts. Now there's darts in the back. On the master pattern, there's darts in the back. But I am not putting the darts in the back because we're putting an elastic waistband in the back. And we don't need darts when we've got elastic. Now, Philly, you saw Philly a couple weeks ago, my best friend Philly. You saw her take the darts completely out of the front. And she put elastic all the way around the waist. You can certainly do that the exact same way we're making it. If you want to put the elastic all the way around, it's just as easy as just putting it in the back. No problem. So here's my two fronts. And they're going to take a nap now. And then I'm going to show you the next step that I'm going to do. The backs and the fronts are all done resting. Their pleats are in. The tucks in the front are in. Now, this is very easy to get wrong if you have not marked the right side and the wrong side of your fabric. If you have a fabric like I'm using that looks exactly the same on both sides, oh my goodness, I have sewn two front legs together before. I have sewn the back side of one piece to the front side of the other piece. I actually made a whole pair of pants that way. And so the front of me was the wrong side and the back of me was the right side, or vice versa. Fortunately, the marks went away and you couldn't really tell. But very easy. That's why I make so many marks. So here's my two fronts. Here's my two backs. I've got the creases in them, so I know what's right side and what's wrong side. So here is a back. Here is a front. I don't know if these two pieces go together or not. I'm going to put the two creases together, right sides together, and look at what I've got here. I've got one crotch going this way, and I've got another crotch going that way. So this can't get sewn together. That can't be right. So I'm going to take the other back. This one, well, that isn't right either. I think, what do I have now? Two fronts. Ta-da! This one has a pleat. That one doesn't have, I mean a dart. This one doesn't have a dart. This is the other back. Yes. So when I put these two together, so the creases are both on the same side and they're touching each other. Here's the dart on the back of the front. Here's the back of the crease on the back, and I've got both crotches going the same way. That's what you have to have. You can't have one crotch going one way, one crotch going the other way. Because this is the side seam over here. This is the side seam. And you have to have this whole side seam together so you can sew it from top to bottom. We're not going to sew this part yet. Just forget that part. You're not sewing that part. We have one of the legs. I don't know which leg it is, but it's one of the legs. I still have not made the low hip correction. This is four pieces cut out by the pattern, and they are all made for my high hip measurement, okay? So, we know these two go together. I am going to stab them with a pin. Let's find a pin. I'm going to stab them with a pin. There, I know those two go together. I'm going to put them on my other table. Now I have my other front, and I have my other back. And I'm going to check them too, just in case I was all crazy and I didn't get that one right, even though I thought I got it right. I'm going to do the same thing to this one. Okay, wrong side of the front, wrong side of the back. I have two crotch curves over here. I am going to sew this pant together. This is the inside inseam. I'm going to sew the inseam, and I'm going to sew the side seam. And I'm going to stab these two with the pin. And I'm going to go over to the sewing machine, and I am going to sew both sets of legs together. I will end up with two long leg tubes. Let's go over to the sewing machine. Most of you probably don't need to watch me sew these two legs together. But for those of you who are new seamstresses and you're not sure what to do, I'm going to show you how I sew the two legs together, okay? I am going to sew them with a straight stitch on 3.0 stitch length. Then I'm going to take them to my serger and I'm going to serge it off. If you don't have a serger, you can cut that seam with pinking shears. Pinking shears are wonderful and they're fast. You just cut it up, leave it about 3/8 inch long, and you will have a seam that will stay 1,000 years. Okay, I'm a pinner. I'm a pinner. Oh yeah, I've watched those classes on Blueprint with Janet Prey. I went to classes years ago with Janet Prey's aunt, Margaret Islander. She was the nicest lady in the whole wide world. I thoroughly enjoyed her classes. So I learned from her about how you don't have to pin, and I learned from Janet Prey about how you don't have to pin, but I don't care, I still pin. All right, let's put this on a 3. I'm not sure what kind of needle I have in here, but it's sewing just fine, so I'm not worried about it. I usually stick a little note, a little post-it note next to my sewing machine saying what the needle is. But then I clean my room and I pick up stuff and throw it away and then it's not here. All right, we're gonna do a 5/8 inch seam. I have my easy feed, even feed put on here. Now I don't have a lot of pins. I've only got about 5 of them. And I'm holding it the Janet Prey way, where you put your hand like this and you turn it like this. Put your hand flat and then turn. And you do that down here at the part that's in your lap. But you do it up here close to the sewing machine, okay? And then you got your tools, you know your best tools. I've told you lots of times what your best tools are. God gave you 10 of them. Oh yeah. God really knew how to make people good, didn't he? Oh my goodness. It's absolutely amazing what our bodies can do and what they can recover from. Oh my goodness. My husband's had cancer twice. Yeah, but he doesn't have it anymore. Okay. That's the side seam. The side seam. All sewn together. I'm doing the inseam now. It's very easy. There's nothing hard about this. Nothing hard at all. Just pinning it together. I am going to do a little cheat. I've lost a little bit of weight. I may have gained it back by now. Who knows? But I had a pair of the pants I made. Oh, they're the ones I just made. There's some I made in a video I did several months ago for you guys when I was making pants. Oh my goodness. I kept falling down, falling down, falling down. Because I've lost a little weight. That's the one thing about pants is, you know, if you get the fit right, your body has to stay the same. That's one reason I really like a little bit of stretch in my fabric and elastic in the back. So, let's sew this. Pants are so fast, so fast. They make up so fast. Especially if you have them cut ready to hem. And with the SureFit Designs pattern system, you should know the length, and your pants should be cut to hem at that length. I can turn this up so a little faster. Want to see? Woo! Let's fly. Come fly with me. All right. Oh, sewing machines are so nice these days, you guys. All right. There it is. Here's my leg. See my leg? I don't know which leg it is. It might be the leg for my high hip. It might be the leg for my low hip. We shall see. I'm going to serge the seams that I just sewed in this leg, but before I do, I'm going to take it out to the three-way mirror, and this is going to be my muslin, even though I'm way past muslin stage, but I've lost a little bit of weight, so I'm going to pull this up on my body, and I'm going to see if I like the fit here through the hip. Okay? So see? See? Isn't it nice? Here's the dart.
This will be on my left side, my high hip. Yeah, look at that. Isn't it nice? I'm here at one of my favorite surgeries now. My favorite surgery is a baby lock surgery because they're so easy to thread. This is the Enlighten. I think I own three of them. This one happens to have kind of a cream colored thread, so I'm just going to use it since it's already threaded. I've got my seams in here. You can see where I sewed a deeper seam right here from when I cut off that sliver. So, if you don't have a serger, it's okay. I used to didn't have a serger. I used to have a $200 Kenmore, and I sewed it on it for many, many, many years. And I made many garments. Garments I wore to work. It always sounds funny. Let me see. You don't oil these, so you can't need oil. The only thing I don't like about the Enlightens is there's no place to catch the scraps, like on the Bernhardt. Unless you buy one. Okay, nothing to it. You're just sewing. You're just sewing. This is the serger. I'm going to show you how pretty it looks when you serge it. Doesn't that look nice? That's what I love about it. I just tried these pants on, and I have to take my usual increase in the side seam. I'm really flat over here. I'm really flat right here. So I don't need this big a curve on the side of me. Plus I've lost a little weight. Now if I went down any further, I'd have to start taking it in on the inseam too. So I'm just going to take it up here. I'm going to come in here and I'm going to mark with my iron away marker how much I have to take this in. Okay, just make some marks back here where you got those pins, and then I'll draw a nice smooth line, not a jaggedy one like I've got now. Then I'm going to take these pins out. Then I'm going to turn my pant leg. This is just one pant leg. This is my left leg. So whatever I do to this leg, I'm going to do to the other leg. And I'm also going to do it to my paper pattern. This is when you use your designing stylus. It has the French curve on it. It's what you drew your hip width to start with. I'm going to use this to correct this hip line over here. Somebody said, do you have to have this? If you're going to buy the SureFit design system, I would say yes, you have to have it. So I can take that to there. It wants to be turned around this way. Sometimes you just have to fiddle with it. Now that's the way it already is. Because you've got to end somewhere. Boy, it just wants to be taken in all that way. Look at that. I might need the straight side of the stylus, actually. Yeah, it wants to be straight. I am just so straight. What is with me? Got a straight butt. Got straight hips. I don't even know how to take that in there. My goodness, let's go this way. Am I inverted? Oh my gosh. Look at that. That doesn't look good. You know, sometimes you just have to use yourself. Sometimes you're so straight, you're not even on the silly curve. Look at that. That is just as straight as it can be. Oh my goodness. That's just embarrassing. So, I'm going to sew this straight right here. It's just going to take this curve off right here. So let me show you if I had a 5/8 inch line where that's going to change this to.
That's going to take off. You'll be able to see how much I'm going to take off now. It's going to take off that much right there. And so, when I cut this little sliver off right here, I'm going to put this sliver up against the other leg. When I get it sewn together, I've only got one sewn together, I'll put this sliver that I'm going to cut off up against the other leg, and then I'll mark that pant to take that much off. It's not really that much, but it will help this fit me better on the side of my body, okay? I'm going to go sew that, and then I'm going to serge it, and then I'm going to sew the other leg, and then I'm going to serge it off, and then I'm going to come back and show you how you sew the crotch together. I wanted to show you this little sliver. Here's my sliver. See my sliver? I have marked that this is the top and this is the bottom. So this is how much I'm going to cut off the side seam of my other leg. I'm going to save it right here so it'll be waiting for me. We now have two legs sewn together. They're tubes, two long tubes. You can stick your arm through there. You can stick your leg through there, of course. So we have two tubes. Here they are. One goes on the left and one goes on the right. I'm going to do something that I do. I don't know if anybody else in the whole wide world does this. I mentioned this in the tips and tricks video. And I showed you a board that fabric comes on. Because at my other house, I don't have one of these. But this is an absolutely wonderful, wonderful thing. It has no name. It has a hole. I have searched the world trying to find this for you. I can't find it. So, remember that you can use one of those boards that the fabric is wrapped around. You just go to the clerk and say, hey, can I have one of those empty boards, and they will give you one. It works just as good. Well, I don't know, this might work a little better. So, we're going to start with one leg. Remember, we already have our creases in the pant. What we want to do is, there's a long seam here, there's a long seam here. I like to press them so they're going opposite directions. How do you do opposite? Opposite directions of each other. So when you fold the pant together, those two seams butt up to each other like if you were doing a quilt block. Okay? I don't know if anybody else on the planet does it like I said, but I do it. So we're going to start on the inseam. Doesn't matter which way you press it, just press it one way or the other. I do like the two inseams to oppose each other when I'm sewing it together, but I hardly ever get that right. I'm going to look and see. Get some pins. Okay, so we're going to play like... You guys know I'm picky and fussy, right? I bet a lot of you are too. Alright, so we're going to play like we're going to sew this inseam to this inseam in the crotch. I want one going that way and I want one going this way. So I am going to put a pin, making that one come toward me. I'm going to pin, making this one go toward you. Then I'm going to take this one back away. I like an iron that steams. Now, do you know about a clapper? A clapper, it's not your hands. It's a wooden block. I'll put a link to this below too. So what a clapper does is it makes the steam stay down in what you just pressed, and it sets it, and it stays a whole lot better. Okay, so I'm going to move this little board down to the bottom, and I'm going to press it the rest of the way down, pulling it apart so there's no pleat or tuck on the right side. I'm going to take my clapper and clap it, and clap it, and clap it. Clap it, clap it, clap it. There you go. I'm going to take another pin and I'm going to pin the seam at the bottom. I'll bring this close to the camera so you can see what I'm talking about. See the pin in the top? That's just telling me make sure this seam goes this way. And there it is at the bottom. And you can see, well, maybe you can see if I hold it still, you can see how nicely pressed that seam is. Now we're going to turn it over and we're going to do this seam. This is the side seam, the long side seam. That's what this seam is, and we're going to make it go the opposite direction of this seam. This one's going that way, so this seam's going to go that way. They're going to go opposite ways. Okay, so this one, and I can't tell you how many times I've gotten this wrong. I check it, and I check it, and I check it about a thousand times. Alright, so that seam's going that way, so this seam has to come toward me. So, I'm going to put a pin in it right there, so I don't forget, it's got to come toward me. Now, when you're pressing, make sure you're just pressing the seam. Don't press the whole pant, because this is inside out. And you don't want to press your creases inside out. So you're only pressing the seam allowance, which has been serged. Okay? You're only pressing it. We went to a lot of trouble to get that crease in there, and we don't want to get it out. Now, another tool that you must have. I have all kinds of them. I have a baby ham. I have teenager ham, and I have a grown-up ham. These make your sewing life so much easier. And this one is super, super, super fun. There's a lady named Sonya, S-O-N-Y-A. S-O-N-Y-A, and she custom makes these. I mean, they're all, I think you can get it maybe bigger, maybe smaller, but you can choose your fabric for the front and your fabric for the back. So I chose this fabric and I chose this fabric, but I didn't make it, Sonya did. And then you can get one of these boards to hold up your grown-up ham. Is that fun? I don't know, you know what? I might love sewing just because of all the fun tools. So what are you telling us that for, Joy? Because I'm getting ready to press the hip area. The hip area, right here. This part. This part isn't flat on your body. So you're going to stick a ham in there, and you're going to press this part of the seam with a ham. And you know, I'm pretty flat there, but I still use a ham. And you'll see the difference. Look at that. Wonderful. It's hard to press a curve if you're doing it on a flat ironing board. Very nice. Very nice. Press that sucker. If I did this right, which will be a small miracle, since I'm trying to talk to you and do it at the same time. This seam goes that way. This seam goes that way. So when I press them together, right side out, these two seams are going to butt up next to each other, and it's going to press really nice like a quilt block. Do you have to do it that way? No. Here's my pants now. These pants aren't even sewn to each other yet. These legs are not sewn to each other yet, but look at how nice they already look. You can see here where I pressed the right side. This sews together nice and flat because there's not two seams going the same way. That makes a ridge, a bump. You can see how nice that looks. There where the seams meet in the middle of the pant. Now it's time to sew these two legs, these two tubes, together. I'll tell you a really good tip right off the bat. One of them has to be right side out, and one of them has to be inside out. Doesn't matter which one. Take one. Put your hand in. Watch the pins. Pull it out. So now, this leg is inside out. This leg is right side out. Why is that? Because we have to get to sew this crotch, this big curve here, There's where your body's going to sit in this big curve. We have to get the right sides together in order to sew it. So you have to put one leg inside the other leg, okay? So we're going to take the right side of this pant and we're going to stick it inside this pant leg because the right side of this pant leg is on the inside. So we're going to take this, the right side out pant leg, and stick it into the wrong side out pant leg. Stick it in there. Pull it down. Watch out for pins. Now, you're going to take those two big curves and you're going to match them up. If you are to this point in your pant and you've got these two legs side by side touching each other, you should have an inside seam showing. Here's an inside seam showing on that side. Turn it around. There's an inside seam showing on this side because the two right sides are touching each other. Look at that. Come to me, come to me. See? Then we're going to pin this big U shape. That's where your bottom's going to go. We're going to pin this big U shape and then I'll let you watch me show it together. I'm going to pin this big U together. I'm going to start at these two seams. These two seams. Right here. There's one. There's one. It's flat the rest of the way up. That's the back. This is flat the rest of the way up. That's the front. This is the bottom of the crotch between your legs. We're going to match these two together and I have one turned one way, one turned the other way. So they're going to match up to each other like in a quilt block. Now these two don't press together. There's going to be one on one leg, one on the other leg, and you can't see my legs. Play like these are my legs. One seam's there, one seam's here. But the center, the part that comes up and touches your body, you're going to be sewing this together. And if you have the seams butting up to each other, it's a much flatter join. Okay? That's the only reason you do it there. Alrighty? I'll be back and we'll sew this U-shape crotch curve together. And after that is when I do my low hip adjustment. Stay with me. I have the crotch pinned together, right sides together. I can see an inside seam here. I can see an inside seam here. I can open it up and see that the right sides are touching. It's not fun ripping all this stuff out. Check it three times, sew it once. It does help if you turn your sewing machine on because this is a new day. And it helps if you take the table off so you have the little arm. Alrighty? So, 5/8 inch seam all the way around. 5/8 inch. And I'm using a stitch length of 3. Alright. Let's sew. Take the pins out, don't sew over them. Much easier to sew around the corner of this U if you don't have that table on there. I think most sewing machines are like this nowadays. Here's my seams that are going to be like a quilt block. And I'm going to go backwards, forwards, because that area gets a lot of stress. Some of the patterns will tell you to sew over it twice. I'm going to serge it so it'll already be sewn over twice. Around and around and around we go. Oh, isn't it fun to sew? I love my sewing room. And I have not done my low hip yet. Both sides, both legs of this pant are identical right now. They are identical. So, what I'm going to do for that low hip adjustment, after I serge this seam, you guys don't need to watch me serge the seam. I'm going to serge all around this crotch, and I'm going to serge it pretty close down here. You want to make sure that this 5/8 inch is cut off pretty low. That's why they have you sew twice there, because you don't want this coming up into your body, and you'll always be pulling your pants down, pulling your pants down. So you want that crotch area right there to be cut pretty low. Quarter of an inch would be great, okay? So, how do I fix the low hip? Pulling my pants apart. I now have a pair of pants without a waistband. Do you see? I have a pair of pants without a waistband. Now, I'm kind of embarrassed to tell you this. But I have many times cut the wrong side down. What happens when I do that? I have to cut the other side down twice as much. That's why I wait until now. I wait until now, and I mark the back. How will I mark the back? I don't have a marker here. Oh, here's one. I'm gonna mark the back. The back is the one with the longest crotch. And I'm gonna write BK. And on the front has the two darts. I'm gonna write F. F. That's on the inside. I'm also gonna write it on the outside, up here where the waistband's gonna sew on. I'm gonna put an F. You see there? See that F? And here at the back, center back, I'm going to put a B, K. Why do you put two letters for the back? I don't know. Why do I do half the things I do? I don't know. So now I've got both sides of the back marked with a B. I've got both sides of the front marked with an F. So now I can play like I'm putting the pants on. Play like I'm putting the pants on. Here's the front, so that means this is the right side, and that means this is the left side. I know that the left side is already right. I don't have to do anything to it. The right side is the one, and I am going to measure down here on the side seam, right here, I'm going to measure down 1/2 inch. Follow me over to the table, and I'll show you how I do it. But let me put a big pin X right there. Just in case, between the sewing machine and the table, I forget what side I'm marking. Now, I have turned this pant, flipped it, brought it over here, turned it upside down, backwards, and everything else. And if I did not have the back marked and the front marked and this pin showing me this is my right side of my body, I could very easily cut the wrong side off. Okay? So what I'm going to do, take these two pins out, and I'm going to put right here an R, just in case. Oh, the phone could ring. Somebody could walk in. Okay, I'm marking this down 1/2 inch. There's my 1/2 inch line right there. Now, I have to taper that to nothing, so I need this to lay here pretty straight. I need to taper that 1 inch line to nothing over here at center back, so I'm going to draw it. I'm going to draw it before I cut it. See there? There's my line. This is the top of the pant here at my right side, which is my low side. Okay, so I've marked that with a stripe. I'm going to turn it over to the front. Now the front's more curvy because it has that dart in it, so it's a little harder to do. But I've done it so many times, I'm going to try to make that act like it's straight, even though it isn't. And I'm going to go from that half inch line over here to the front. It's really hard to do when it's not completely straight. But it'll work. There. So there's my line. There's my line in the front. See? I'm going to cut this off. I'm going to cut this on that blue line. And that makes the right side of this pant 1/2 inch lower at the side, and then it tapers to nothing in the center. So that is how I do it. My pant is now ready. It's now ready for a waistband. I'm gonna go get some lunch and I'll be back. Stay with me. We're ready to do the waistband now. So the first thing you want to do in this kind of a waistband, remember our waistband is going to be flat in the front and it's going to have elastic in the back. So what I did was I matched up the center front of my waistband to my pant and I moved it over here to the side seam and I held it with my finger. Then I moved it over here to this side seam and I held it with my finger. So this much of this waistband is going to be on the front of me. So I have a piece of interfacing here. I'm using a little heavier interfacing. This is Palmer Plush's Tailor. So it's a little stiffer and I want it stiff because I want that waistband to stand up. So I'm just going to measure from here to here and make a mark. Make a mark. This is my waistband. It's just a flat piece, one layer of a waist of interfacing. That's what I'm using. It's a little stiffer. It stretches one way, it does not stretch the other way. I'm making it so the stretch stretches with the waistband around me. Going up and down, it won't stretch. So I'm going to put this waistband right here over to the mark I made. I'm going to line it up because that's how much I need. No, this isn't the center of the waistband. I'm just using it as a measuring tape right now, okay? And this is how wide I need it. So I'm going to take my quilting ruler. You all can see I'm a quilter. I'm getting ready to finish this one right here. This is Edita Sitar's Winter Village. But that has nothing to do with making pants. But I know you always ask me, what's that in the background? All right. This is my new Quilter Select ruler, which, oh my goodness, they are wonderful. Even if you don't quilt, having these quilting rulers makes your sewing so much easier. So, I'm going to go over to the sewing machine. See, this is the front. This interfacing will be right here inside the waistband. So I'm going to go over to the ironing board and I'm going to iron this interfacing to this waistband. I will fold it in half, find its center front, then I will line it up. I've got the wrong side marked with all these X's. I will put the center front of the interfacing to the center front of the waistband, just like that, and I will iron it on there. So all of that side that's left, that's going to go around my back, and that's going to have a seam in the center back. I will probably cut several inches off of it. I hope I'll cut several inches off of it. Now you know that these interfacings come with little glue dots on them. Maybe you don't know, all of you, you new seamstresses. Interfacing is wonderful these days because one side of it's got glue dots and you can just iron it down to your fabric. It's wonderful. Okay, so center of the interfacing and center of the waistband, which is just the fold. Remember, I cut the waistband the full width of this fabric. So just the center of that, okay? We're gonna get a press cloth. Do you know about press cloths? The best press cloths in the whole wide world are these organza ones. I used to buy them at Hancock's. I don't know where you can get them now, though, but I know you can still get them. If I can find them on Amazon, I'll put a link to that, too. I'll put a link to everything down there. Makes it easy. You just click on it. Read the directions on your interfacing package. See if you're supposed to steam it, not steam it. Hold it down for 5 seconds. Hold it down for 30 seconds. Read the directions that come with your interfacing. Alrighty. Now, that is ironed down. So this is the center front of my waistband. I am going to press it in half. The whole length, I'm going to press in half. Now, if you draw your waistband with the SureFit Designs Master Pattern, you're going to have some notches and some marks. I don't need those for this kind of a waistband because it's going to have elastic. The front is just going on 1-to-1, and the back is too big already because we made the top of the pant too big. Why did we make the top of the pant too big? We made it too big for our waist, but we did not make it too big for our hip. Because the pant has to pull up, it doesn't have a zipper. It has to pull up over the widest part of your tummy and your hip, okay? So, that's why we have to bring it back in with elastic. Otherwise, our pants would just not stay up. And we look like those crazy kids wear their pants. Oh my gosh, I just saw some guy, Jerry and I just couldn't even believe what we were seeing. Was it the Oscars, the Academy Awards, something? And the guy was singing some song we couldn't understand a single word of. It was rap. We had no idea. The audience all seemed to know what the words were. The guy's pants were halfway down his butt. They were put in here with a belt. I thought, oh my gosh, that would be torture if I had to wear something like that. What is wrong with these people? And then, you know, every young person goes out and thinks, oh, that's really nice, I'm going to wear mine like that. And then they just look like morons. In my opinion, turn to your neighbor and say, she's always giving us her opinion. And I always will be. Okay, here we go. This is half our waistband. This is center front. It's going to wrap around to the back like this. I will be taking probably this much. Look how much that is. I'll probably be taking that much off the ends. Okay? That's why I cut it the whole width of the fabric, because you can figure out what length it needs to be at this time of the process of sewing this pant together. Alright, you got your pant. You got your waistband. We're going to put the two together. The crotch seam is serged and pressed. Which way do you press the crotch seam? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at all. The only thing that matters is that you press the same way the entire length of the U. Okay? Now I'm going to take a pin. And I am going to pin it in here so I'm sure I don't turn the crotch seam around when I'm pinning the waistband on. Okay? Because seams don't stay put until you cross another seam over them. Alright? So, I'm going to take the waistband. We're going to find center front of the waistband. We're going to match it up with center front of the pant. And we're going to put a pin in it. Then we're going to just pull this. I'm stretching it just a teeny weeny bit. Just a teeny weeny bit. Over to the side seam. Just a tad, because the pant stretches. They both stretch to the same fabric. But I just want to make sure that it stays nice and flat against my roly-poly waist. All right, so there we are. Center front, side seam, and a pin in the middle. Now we're going to go the other way. Center front to side seam, 1 to 1. And then I'm just going to pull it a tad, 1/8 of an inch, just a tad, just to put a little tension. And that's not enough tension, that's still 1 to 1. Just a little tension. Tension is good in material. Alright, now let's look and see which way the darts are supposed to be. I've got one going one way, one going the other. So I'm going to pin the darts going the same direction toward the center. Okay? So the two, here's side seam, side seam, center front, dart area, okay? I have that all pinned. Now, we're going to do the same thing in the back. We have to make sure this waistband is going to come up over our hip and our belly. We have to make sure. So, what I'm going to do is pin it at center back. Let me make a mark. Center back, it's right there. Then I'm going to take this other side and I'm going to bring it around to the center back. And I'm going to make a mark right there. So, I have two marks. See my two marks? You can see them, I can't. Here's one, and here's one. I'm going to go take a seam in this waistband, and I'm going to sew it together. Then I'm going to take it off these pants, and I am going to go in the other room, and I'm going to pull it up on my body to make sure it comes over my hip, over my belly, and up to my waist. That's what I'm going to do. An extra step? Yes. But you would be very, very sorry if you got this all put together. Here goes pins that I just put in there. You'd be very, very sorry if you went to all this trouble and put that elastic in there and everything else, and the thing would not come up over your hip and your belly. So we're going to open this up. I'm not going to cut anything off yet. I'm not going to cut anything off, because if this won't come up over me, I'm going to be in trouble. In fact, I think I'm just going to do a quick pin. Now, this is a really good way to hurt yourself. Is to be lazy and don't go sew it. Just pin it. Just pin it. And fold it. And I am going to go ahead and cut off some of this. We certainly don't need all of that. We may need a little bit of it, but we don't need all of it. Good Lord, we're not that big. Okay, so I've shortened it a lot, but I've got to shorten a little bit more. I have enough here that I can add on if I need to. All right? So, I'm going to fold this in half. So look what I've done. I've just pinned. I've pinned the seam in. That's where I want to sew a seam. But instead of sewing it right now, I am going to try to put it up on my body with these pins in it and hope that one doesn't end up permanently embedded in my backside. Okay? All right, I'll just let you watch me. I'm going to pull this up with the pins in the front so I don't impale myself. I can see them and watch them. How high? Look here. And I have a pair of jeans on. Look there, it comes easily up, easily up. I can get it on because it's stretchy. It's got a little bit of stretch in it, and boy, I love that. And why do I love having a little bit of stretch in this? Because you don't have to have it 6 inches longer. If there was no stretch in this, it would have to be much longer because there wouldn't be any stretch factor. Let me see how far it stretches. Probably doesn't stretch that far. Let's look and see. It's at 19 and a half. I can stretch this from 19 and a half to 21 and a half. 19 and a half to 21 and a half. And that's folded in half. So that's a lot of stretch in this waistband. And that means I won't have to have a zillion million gathers in the back part of the waistband. Okay? All I'm gonna do is pin it right back on just like I showed you. And then I'm going to sew it on. And then I will be back. Let me show you this. This is the waistband without the pins. I sewed where the pins were. I sewed across it 2.5. I wanted a tighter seam there, and then I serged it. Now I'm going to fold it in half lengthwise. This seam will be in the center back. There will not be any seams anywhere else on this waistband. This seam will be in the center back of the pant. And I'm going to do my little trick that I like to do. And I'm going to cut this right in the center. Right there. Because I want to turn one way and one the other way. And fold them together so we have a crisscross again to match up to each other. And since it's enclosed like that, I don't think it'll ever ravel or ever come apart. If you want to, put a little dab of glue there. All right, so that's the center back of the waistband now. Ah, how nice is that? Now let me just tell you one little thing we're gonna do on the waistband. The waistband is finished in the front, it's not in the back, because we have to thread the elastic through it. So we are going to leave about a 2-inch opening. When we're sewing the waistband on, we're gonna leave a 2-inch unsewn area right here and right here. On the side, a little bit toward the front, a little bit toward the front, and the rest toward the back. We're going to leave an opening not sewn so we can slip the elastic up in there, slide it back and forth, attach it at one end, put the pan on, pull it, see if we need more, see if we need less, mess with the elastic. After we get the elastic in there, we will leave enough that it extends past the side seam. Then we will finish sewing. When do you sew that on? You sew that on, I'll show you when I get to that part, okay? But you want a little bit of elastic. I especially want a little bit of elastic. I'll probably leave at least 1/2 inch. Because if I gain the 5 pounds I just lost, if I gain it back again, I'll open it up and I'll extend that out and it'll give me a little more stretch, right? I'm sewing on the band now. I'm still gonna leave my table off. And I'm going to use the open arm. Now, so I don't forget, I'm going to give myself a guide. I know that the two darts are in the front, so I know this is front, I know that's center front, I know this is a side seam, and I know this is the back. Right here on the side seam, I'm going to put a line that says don't sew here. And I'm going to take another pin and I'm going to cross it over the pin that's there. That's like, hello, Joy! This means something! Stop sewing when you get here! So let me find the other side seam. There's center back, center front. Here's the side seam. I'm going to take my marker that has now disappeared. Where did you go? I tell you what. Your markers just disappear. I'm sure you guys saw where it went. Could you please tell me, where'd my marker go? Where it is over here. So I'm going to do the same thing. That's the back. I want the biggest opening to be in the back, about 1.5 inches, and I want a little bit to be toward the front. So I've marked that, and here's my pin. I know that I never put two pins, because you certainly can't sew over that. That's just a signal to me that says something different happens here. So as I'm sewing all the way around the pant, I'm going to stop. I'm going to lock my stitches, stop, move forward 1.5 inches, lock my stitches again, sew all the way around to that other marked line, and do the same thing, because I'm leaving those two areas open so I have a place to put my elastic. Let's start. I'm going to sew this with 3 again, just in case something happens and I make a mistake. Knowing that I'm prone to that. All right, this must be the front. Do you have a dart? Yes, you do. You can always remember those darts are in the front. We didn't put the darts in the back, remember? Yeah, and then what you'll end up doing is cutting a bunch of it off. You'll serge it and cut a bunch of it off. Take your pins out. Check your side seams to make sure that they're going the direction you told them to go. Because when you're sewing on your sewing machine, they can turn around. Your machine can catch them and make them turn the wrong way. All right, here's my other green line. Elastic. Now you remember in my earlier video, I showed you how I turned the end of the elastic to make it a little bulkier. And I stick the pin in it and I wrap tape around the pin head. Then I find a pair of scissors and I cut the tape off because you can't get the pin off if you don't. Now, when I was putting this elastic in here, it twisted. But it's very easy to just figure out where it twisted and catch it and turn it around. Okay, you can see here I have a mile of elastic hanging out here. I'm going to leave it there. I am. See? Now my elastic is in the back. I probably will have to pull it much, much, much tighter. I'll probably have to pull it more like that. See? I'm going to go in the other room in the mirror. I'm going to take my jeans off. I'm going to pull these up. I'm going to put this around my waist. I'm going to bend. I'm going to stretch. I'm going to walk. I'm going to move. And I'm going to see how exactly long I want this elastic to be. Then I'm going to cut it off or mark it. I might just mark it and put a pin, and then I'll show you how to finish. We're almost done. We are almost done. All we have left is the hem. I don't think you need me to show you how to hem it, do you? I'll show you a quick spot of that, okay? Try on is over. I tried the pants on. I was so happy with them. So instead of having a mile of elastic hanging out, I only have that much elastic hanging out. Let me give you a tip. This is a really, really good safety tip. When you're messing with the back of your pants and the elastic, use safety pins. Don't use straight pins. I have hurt myself really, really bad putting straight pins deep into my fingers, messing with the back. So I'm going to go over to my sewing machine. I'm going to push this piece up in, up inside the band, up in here with my finger. Remember I told you I was going to leave a little extra just in case? So I'm sticking that up in there so it's going toward the front. There won't be any tension on the front, but it's going toward the front. Then, on this side, I am going to sew 2 lines of stitching right here, right at the side seam. I'm going to do it first so I can take that pin out. I'm going to sew some stitching right here, then I'm going to stitch this closed on the inside. Then I'm going to go to the other side and do the same thing. I've still got my table off, because I'm not completely done with this yet. So I am going to sew. I'm going to make sure my elastic, I'm pushing it with my fingers So it's all the way up to the top of this band. And we'll pin it there. I'm going to pin underneath it so it can't slide down. Then I'm going to sew a line of stitching with a 3. I may pull this out later and make a prettier one, I don't know. But for now, in fact, I'm going to put it on a 4. I'm going to put it on a basting stitch just to hold it. See? I just sewed it right there, a straight stitch, basting stitch. Now I can remove this pin. I can remove this safety pin. And now that elastic is not going anywhere. And I've got an inch, I've got probably an inch and a half sticking into the front, but there's no tension on it. But that gives me extra elastic in case I need to give myself more room later. And which is wonderful, because what happened years ago when I made so many pair of pants, I gained some weight, and then the pants were too tight for me. And so all my hard work just sat in the closet for years. 5/8 inch. All right, so I just sewed that side on. You remember the green line and how I left it open? There's the green line, and it's now all sewn shut. And I will serge this entire seam off. This waistband is sewn on the entire way around. The elastic is in the back. That's another really nice thing about these pants. You can open up one of these side seams that you just sewed shut. So you just unsew the band there where that green mark is, and then you can pull your elastic tighter. Okay? I think that I should do that before I serge it. So let me just do a pretend. Oh yeah, that's good. That's real good. Are you all ready for spring? I am so ready for spring. All right, I'm going to come around where you guys are, over here to my serger, and I am going to serge this. Then, all I have to do is put the hem in the bottom and wear these pants. I'm almost completely around this waistband, serging it up, but I wanted to show you something important. This is stretchy. Remember, it has a little bit of stretch. Yours might not, but either way, you need to hold it in the front and in the back. If you have a woven, you'll just hold it. Just relaxed, hold it. Don't pull it. If you pull it, you'll break your needle. Do not pull it. Really easy to do. Guess how I know? You don't want to break your needle, but you don't want this to sew with this all rumpled up because of the elastic, so you have to stretch it. But stretch it and don't pull it. I'm pulling it toward me and just holding it in the back. Okay? And that way, it won't break your needle. There we go. You can see the elasticy part, that's the back. And then you can see the smooth part, that's the front. So, I'll just press that. I'll press all of that down into the pant. You don't have to top stitch it or anything. Some elastics will allow you to sew through them, but this one won't. And it's not necessary. And I used that kind of a stiff elastic so it'll stand up good in there. And see, here's the front with the interfacing. Okay, so you're going to turn your pants inside out. Inside out. You have a raw edge down here at the bottom of these legs. You have a raw edge. I'm going to serge that edge. And then I'm going to fold it up and hem it. But before I serge it, I'm going to press the hem allowance into it. Okay, and I am going to use my sleeve board. I'm thinking this was an inch. If I knew where my pattern was, which I don't at the moment, I would go look. But I'm going to say it was an inch, I think. Let's try an inch and see if it plays good. Yeah, an inch plays real good. Because there's an allowance in the pattern for fold up of the hem, so it will touch the fabric. You know, as you go higher up the pant width changes. So you need your hem to allow for that. So that's why you have to hem it the way you cut it. And I can tell that this was an inch now. All right, inch. An inch. I'm hitting it at the side seams. I'm just going to press it in between because I want to go and serge it. Am I going to use the steamer seam? I don't think it's necessary. This is not that stretchy. If you have something very stretchy, you want to use the steamer seam, or when you sew your seam in, it'll be all rumpledy-umpledy. That's why you use the steamer seam. This one's a little off. Check it, over and over. 1 inch. Of course, I'm a perfectionist, so I have seen Angela Wolf. Of course, Angela Wolf does this for a living. But I have seen her just do the pin up each side and just pop it like this and sew it in. I'm not that trusting of my popping skills. If you are, then go for it. But I'm not. All right. Okay. So now I'm going to take this over to the serger and I'm going to serge all the way around that edge. But first I've got to do the other leg. I'm going to do this leg just like the other leg. I don't have to hem my short side any different than my long side. Do you know why? I used to always have to, still do if I buy store-bought pants, I always have to hem the right leg higher by 1/2 inch. But I don't have to do it when I make pants because the actual difference in the length of my legs is in my hip. I had a chiropractor tell me that once. I said, I have one leg shorter than the other one. He said, no, you don't. They're perfect. Your legs are the same. The difference is in your hips. Well, okay then. I guess that makes you wiggle when you walk. Did you know that Marilyn Monroe, crazy what comes to your mind, Marilyn Monroe used to have the heel of one shoe cut off 1/4 inch shorter. So the one shoe would be longer and one would be shorter, and when she walked it would make her wiggle more. So, lucky for me, I have a built-in natural wiggle. I was so excited when I heard that. I thought, oh my gosh, God made me this way on purpose. And so I can wiggle when I walk and giggle when I talk. And I do. So we've got both of them pressed up. I'm going to go serge both of them and I'll be back. Here's another little tip. I have my pants turned inside out to serge this hem edge because you cannot get this to wrap around your serger. It's too big. So you can serge when you have a small circle and you can't get it, you know, to lay flat, serge it from the inside. And I just pick a place on this foot to line it up with, and then I just go all the way around it. So the right side is on the inside and the wrong side's on the outside. And this needs a pad under it so it will quit scooching all over the place. There you go. All right. So now I'm going to go over to my sewing machine. I've already got the open arm on and you can see me. Let's just walk over there. I've still got the pant leg inside out. Folding the hem up on that crease line that I made, wrapping it over the open arm, and I'm sewing it from the inside. I'm using a 3-stitch. I've moved my needle over to where I want it to sew exactly on the edge. And I'm still stretching it just a little bit, just holding it in front and back so it'll be flat, 1 back stitch. This is such a nice fabric because it stretches just a little. Back stitch, cut. Hem done. Hem done. Beautiful. Hem is done. That's the inside. Turn my pants right side out. This pant is ready to wear. Oh my goodness. It's ready to wear. I'm gonna go downstairs in my closet, find a top that matches it, and then I'm gonna put it on and model it for you. First, I'm going to the iron to give it a last press. Then I'll be back for my last clip.